Now we will see Votician order statistic tree. The ith order statistic of a set of n element is the ith smallest element. For example, the minimum of a set of elements is the first order statistics and the maximum is the nth order statistics. We know to determine any order statistic in order of n time from an unordered set using median of medians method. In this video, we shall see how to modify that tree so that we can determine any order statistics for a dynamic set in order of log n time. So the prerequisites of this video is a red-black tree. We shall also see how to compute the rank of an element in order of log n time. Figure shows a data structure that can support first order statistics operation. An order statistic tree T is simply a red-black tree with an additional information stored in each node. Beside the usual red-black tree attributes x.key, x.color, x.p, x.left and right, in a node X, we have another attribute, x.size. This attribute contains the number of internal nodes in the subtree rooted at X, including X itself. That is the size of the subtree. So, at any node, size of the subtree is x.size equal to x.left.size plus x.right.size plus 1. We do not require keys to be distinct in an order statistic tree. For example, the tree in figure has two keys with the value 14 and two keys with the value 21 in the presence of equal keys. The above notion of rank is not well defined. We remove this ambiguity for an order statistic tree by defining the rank of an element as the position at which it would be printed in an in-order traversal of the tree. In figure, for example, the key 14 stored in a black node has rank 5 and the key 14 stored in the red node has rank 6. Now we will see select operation in order statistic tree. Before we show how to maintain this size information during insertion and deletion, let us examine the implementation of two order statistics queries that use this additional information. We begin with an operation that retrieves an element with a given rank. The procedure OX select X, I returns a pointer to the node containing the ith smallest key in the subtree rooted at X. To find the node with the ith smallest key in an order statistic tree T, we call OS select T dot root comma I. You can see a pseudo code of a select operation in slide. In line 1 of OS select, we compute R, the rank of node X within the subtree rooted at X. The value of X dot left dot size is number of nodes that come before X in an in order tree walk of the subtree rooted at X. Thus, x.left.size plus 1 is the rank of x within the subtree rooted at x. If I equal to r, then node x is the ith smallest element and so we return x in line 3. If I less than r, then the ith smallest element reside in x left subtree and so we recurse on x.left in line 5. If I greater than r, then the ith smallest element reside in x right subtree. Since the subtree rooted at x contains r elements that come before x right subtree in an in-order tree walk, the ith smallest element in the subtree rooted at x is the I minus rth smallest element in the subtree rooted at x dot right. Line 6 determines this element recursively. To see how OS select operates, consider a search for the 17th smallest element in the order statistics tree of figure. We begin with X as the root, whose key is 26 and with I equal to 17. Since the size of 26 left subtree is 12, its rank is 13. Thus, we know that the node with rank 17 is the 17 minus 13 equal to 4th smallest element in 26 right subtree. After the recursive goal, X is the node with key 41 and I equal to 4. Since the size of 41's left subtree is 5, its rank within its subtree is 6. Thus, we know that the node with rank 4 is the 4th smallest element in 41's left subtree. After the recursive goal, X is node with the key 30 and its rank within its subtree is 2. Thus, we recurse once again to find the 4 minus 2 equal to 2nd smallest element in the subtree rooted at the node with key 38. We now find that its left subtree has size 1, which means it is second smallest element. Thus, the procedure returns a pointer to the node with the key 38. Because each recursive call goes down one level in the order statistic tree, the total time for OS select is at worst proportional to the height of the tree. Since the tree is a red-black tree, its height is order of log n, where n is the number of nodes. Thus, the running time of OX select is order of log n time for a dynamic set of n elements. Now we will see rank operation in an order statistic tree. Given a pointer to a node X in an order statistic tree T, the procedure OS rank returns the position of X in the linear order determined by an in-order tree of Markov tree. You can see the pseudocode of rank operation in a slide. We first initialize value of r and y. After that, we go up to the root of tree and we add the rank of parent node if node is right child of parent node. Otherwise, we simply go up. As an example, when we run OS rank on the order statistics tree to find the rank of the node with the key 38, we get the following sequence of value of r at the top of the while loop. Loop iterate only 4 times. You can see the visualization in video. The procedure returns the rank 17, since each iteration of the while loop takes order of 1 time, and y goes up 1 level in the tree with each iteration. The running time of OS rank is at worst proportional to the height of the tree, order of log n, on an n node order statistic tree. Now we will see how to maintain subtree sizes. Given the size attribute in each node, OS select and OS rank can quickly compute order statistics for information. But unless we can efficiently maintain these attributes within the basic modifying operation on red-black trees, our work will have been for naught. We shall now show how to maintain subtree sizes for both insertion and deletion without affecting the asymptotic running time of either operation. We know that insertion into a red-black tree consists of two phases. The first phase goes down the tree from the root, inserting the new node as a child of an existing node. The second phase goes up the tree, changing colors and performing rotation to maintain the red-black properties. To maintain the subtree sizes in the first phase, we simply increment x dot size for each node x on the simple path traverse from the root down toward the leaves. The new node added gets a size of 1. Since there are order of log n nodes on the traverse path, the additional cost of maintaining the size attribute is order of log n. In second phase, the only structural changes to the underlying red-black tree are caused by rotation, of which there are at most 2. Moreover, a rotation is a local operation. Only 2 nodes have their size attributes invalidated. The link around which the rotation is performed is incident on these nodes. Since at most 2 rotations are performed during insertion into a red-black tree, we spend only order of 1 additional time updating size attributes in the second phase. Thus, the total time for insertion into an n node order statistic tree is order of log n, which is asymptotically the same as for an ordinary red-black tree. We add following 2 lines in right rotate operation of red-black tree. This visualization shows how the attributes are updated. We add following 2 lines in left rotate operation of red-black tree. This visualization shows how the attributes are updated in left rotate operation. Deletion from a red-black tree also consists of 2 phases. The first operates on the underlying search tree, and the second causes at most 3 rotations and otherwise performs no structural changes. The first phase either removes 1 node Y from the tree or moves upward it within the tree. To update the subtree sizes, we simply traverse a simple path from node Y, starting from its original position within the tree up to the root, decrementing the size attribute of each node on the path. Since this path has length order of log n in an n node red-black tree, the additional time spent maintaining size attributes in the first phase is order of log n. We spend only order of 1 additional time updating size attributes in the second phase, in the same manner as for insertion. Thus, Both insertion and deletion, including maintaining the size attributes, take order of log n time for an n node order statistics tree. Thank you.